Acting Prime Minister Richard Marles has hit out at speculation that the date of Australia Day would be changed if the voice to Parliament succeeds. Richard Marles has told Today on Nine the government is focused on First Nations people being recognised in the Constitution.
No, no. And all of that is about trying to create distraction away from what should be the central issue here, and that is recognising our First Nations people in the Constitution, which Australians want to see happen.
The next step in legislating a voice to Parliament will begin today with the first public hearings to get underway.
Welcome back from spectacular Adelaide. We are live here all morning and it's wonderful to see you joining us. Thanks so much for your company. OK, well, let's move on now to the voice to Parliament, which has gained more momentum this week with AFL legend Eddie Betts throwing his support behind it. Joining us to discuss today's headlines, Tom Wren, Nine Adelaide presenter, and Wayne Swan, ALP National President. Good morning
to you
both. So good to have you here with us, Tom. How good is this?
Great to be here. I mean, what an atmosphere. Awesome. You're doing a great job. It's fantastic to have the
sun's
entire
just coming
Today
up.
Show.
It's gorgeous.
Beautiful day. Gorgeous. You know Adelaide well, so thanks, thanks for having me.
No, it's wonderful to be here. Hey, Wayne, let's go to the voice because we're seeing that it's gaining some momentum. There's also been some divisions, multiple sporting stars throwing their support behind the voice. How much of an influence do you think this is having?
Oh, I think it's great that prominent people and sports stars are out there supporting the voice. It's a reform that's long overdue and there is some disagreement about it. So it's good to see people from right across the community coming out in support.
I know, I guess it makes it feel like Peter Dutton's on a bit of an island, Tom, don't you reckon?
I think so. And with people like Eddie Betts coming out, who's been such a prominent voice here in South Australia and I think around the country, I really struggled to see why we can't officially recognise Indigenous people and give them a voice. And I think it's a bit of a shame that Peter Dutton is using Alice Springs to create headlines. So I think, you know, we should as a nation be uniting behind this. And I think if people like Eddie Betts can get behind it, I think it can only be a positive thing.
Yeah, absolutely. And I guess we need to see how the divisions play out within the Liberal Party. Swanee, it's looking ugly there, isn't it?
Well, Peter can't unite his own party over this question, so he can't unite the country around any of the solutions. I mean, all of the old practices, all of the things that haven't worked are out there for everybody to see. So why don't we just try something different for once?
You've got a pretty big week ahead, don't you? I know in terms of the voice, there is some speculation this morning, at the very least, that you may change the date of Australia Day. Is that true? Is that coming next?
No. I think Australians want to see our First Nations people recognised in our Constitution through a voice to Parliament. That's what we're focused on. And that will be a hugely uplifting moment for the nation if we can pass that referendum. And I think this is a moment that can bring the country together. And really, that's what we're crying out for. And I think there's the opportunity for the Liberal Party, for Peter to get on board here. The step that Julie and Lisa took this week is obviously a step of real moral courage to follow his conscience. The question is whether Simon Birmingham's now going to do the same. But what we need to see is the whole country coming together behind this, because I think that's what Australians want to see.
But of changing Australia Day, that's not coming next, though? Changes to the flag, anthems?
No. And all of that is about trying to create distraction away from what should be the central issue here, and that is recognising our First Nations people in the Constitution, which Australians want to see happen.
OK, Peter Dutton has been accused of playing political games with his trip to Alice Springs. The Northern Territory Police Minister even accusing him of a dog act. Are your response to those claims?
I think it's really important that we're not making Alice Springs a political football. A lot of work has gone on here to try and improve the situation in Alice Springs. And we've been very hands-on in this regard. Linda Burney's been there a number of times in the last few months. She's going back in the next couple of weeks. Since the Prime Minister was there in January, we've worked with the Northern Territory Government to put in place restrictions on alcohol. That has now seen all the stats trending in the right direction, both in terms of crime and alcohol-related violence. We're putting in place the funding in an ongoing sense, which under the former government was due to come to an end in the middle of this year. Yeah. That's going to make a real difference as well. And I think, again, we need to be working with each other to try and improve the situation in Alice Springs rather than make it a political football at this moment in time.
Pretty strong employment figures. You must be buoyed by that. But now the threat of of looming increased interest rates is a worry for most families across the country.
Well, we understand the pressure that the global inflationary environment has placed upon Australians, and that's why a real focus of our government since coming to power has been easing the pressures on, in relation to the cost of living, cheaper medicines, doing what we did in December of last year to ease the pressure on energy bills within people's households. So we're very focused on this. Employment is a key factor here, and we are buoyed by the positive employment figures, but we understand there's a long way to go in terms of focusing on those cost of living pressures. And what people know that they will get with the Albanese government is a government which is really focused on these bread and butter issues and doing everything it can to make sure that we do help households get through what is a very difficult time.
It's difficult, all right. Look, a couple of quick ones. Religious schools across the country are under fire this morning over a move to exclude gay students or those having premarital sex from becoming school captain. I mean, I don't even know where you start with that. Your thoughts?
Look, we obviously respect the views of people of faith. We've been working hard to make sure that in all our anti-discrimination legislation that we are protecting people of faith. But we've been very clear as we've walked this road over a number of years now that as we do that, we can't see a situation where we're inadvertently discriminating against kids. It's really important that that not happen. And that's, you know, why I feel a bit uncomfortable about the reports that we've seen in the papers today. I mean, obviously, leadership and the qualities of leadership are not a function of people's sexual orientation, and we need to make sure that we have the widest pool of people for leadership positions across our society, and that should apply here as well. But it's really important that we do not see, as we walk down this road, discrimination against children, and that's our bottom line
here. I agree with you 100%. Look, you were supposed to go up against Peter Dutton today. We're having communications issues with him, but I figure you're enjoying this a little bit more, just talking to me, having me on your own this morning. We're broadcasting live
Peter's
from Adelaide.
I think Peter's making the best contribution he has so far.
Oh, fighting words.
He's not had a great couple of weeks. How do you reckon he's going while he can't hear us?
Oh, well, I think he's done really well today. This is the strategy, obviously, that he put in place in the lead-up to the Aston by-election, and we saw the result
there.
I think we've set the tone now, going forward.
Silence your opponent.
Good on you, Richard. We're broadcasting from Adelaide today, your favourite part of the city, and you can't say the South Australian Premier. That's the only thing you can't say.
Well, I'm a big fan of the South Australian Premier, but I know I've seen the picture of where you're broadcasting from right now. The Adelaide Oval is spectacular. There are great golf courses, I might say, as a golf aficionado in Adelaide as well. Mm. And I think that the Adelaide beaches, particularly for young kids, are one of the great undiscovered secrets of this country. So, big fan of Adelaide.